The latest now on breaking news. We're getting word that standoff in Gardner is over.
KMBC 9's Brenda Washington live on the scene right now with the very latest. Hi, Brenda.
Hi, guys. Well, that standoff is indeed over. And in fact, I'm here with the Gardner Police Chief, Gerald Cullenberg. He says this really was not a standoff. They were just taking their time trying to wait the suspect out, basically. But the story is about 1 o'clock this morning, the two suspect and the victim got into some sort of a fight. One stabbed the other. The victim met police there in the 1000 block of Buffalo while the suspect ran back to his home about a half block away. So, Chief, pick it up from there and tell us what happened.
Well, just the individual got back into the side of his residence, and we just made the decision to take advantage of all the technology and the support that we have from Johnson County Sheriff's Department and not really endanger anyone's life any further, and just decided to call them in to assist us on this call. So we just went in, asked them to come down. They set up. We obtained a search warrant, went in the residence, and when we were making entry into the residence, the suspect met us at the door, and we took him into custody without incident. And that's really what we work for. It was a good ending. No one got hurt. Suspect's in custody. We have our victim at the hospital who's going to be kept for 48 hours observation. So it's just what we work for in this type of career.
What was the motive in all this, do you believe?
Oh, I think it probably has some domestic tones to it, in a sense that I think the individual who was the victim probably or was seen with the suspect's ex-wife or girlfriend.
And you believe that perhaps alcohol may have fueled a lot of this too?
You know, Brandon, all my years, in most of these situations, alcohol plays a factor. I do not and cannot say with 100% certainty that it was, but I would not be surprised. I would not be surprised if it has.
One last question. Now, we talked with some folks who say they were evacuated because they lived nearby that mobile home. Are they being let back in now?
Yes, they are. And that's just a standard precaution because, again, anytime we have a situation like this, we want to make sure that we protect the public, that we protect the officers, and that, you know, we make safety our absolute paramount reason to do it.
Chief, thank you very much. Again, as you just heard, a suspect that they were after now in custody. The victim in all of this also, the stabbing victim, being treated at the hospital for a non-life-threatening injury. So, from Gardner, Brenda Washington, KMBC 9 News.